I am going to design a new research study using ChatGPT. I'm going to make this a little bit easy for myself, so I will design this new study on the basis of an existing research paper. I will use one of my own papers, which I published last year, actually just 2 months ago. This was published just in November. I'm going to take my abstract and ask, interesting abstract. I'm going to just paste it here. So for the new study that I am designing, let's generate some possible research questions. So I will say, I want to conduct a follow-up study on this one. Write me 3 possible research questions for the follow-up. Say we choose question number 1 as the main research question for my follow-up study. Let's have ChatGPT formulate some hypotheses for it. Formulate 5 hypotheses for question number 1. Now, to collect data to test these hypotheses, we're going to need survey items. We'll ask for them. Formulate the necessary survey items to test hypothesis. Okay, please develop these survey items in full. Okay, not perfect, but solid enough. We could do this for all the hypotheses, and then we have pretty much a full survey. Now, next step. For my follow-up study, I'm going to need a proper sample size and a sampling method. So, we ask. Recommend a proper sample size for my follow-up study. And what sampling method should I use? Alright, so cluster sampling or stratified sampling recommended. Fine. Let's say we have now collected the data. Let's have ChatGPT help us with analyzing the data. For this, I'm going to feed some fake data to ChatGPT and we can play around with it a little bit. We're going to do a correlation, a t-test, and a regression just for fun. So I have some data here. Copy, paste. Yes, so write the R code for correlation between variables 1 and 2. Write our code for a t-test between 1 and 2. Now, write the R code for a regression analysis using V1 to predict V2. All right, let's say now I have done all the analysis, I have my results, but I need help writing the discussion chapter. So let's ask for some theoretical implications here. And for this demonstration, since we don't have the actual results, we're going to ask for theoretical implications based on the results from the existing abstract, just for demonstration. So we're going to say, based on the in the abstract, write 3 theoretical implications. Okay. Write 3 theoretical implications on the basis of the abstract I provided. Expand on your point number 1. Good. Enough with the theoretical implications. Now let's come up with some practical implications. Based on the abstract provided to you, please write 3 practical applications for hotel managers. Based on the abstract provided, write three practical implications for hotel management educators. Formulate three possible titles for the study described in the abstract provided. All right. Make these titles funnier. Check out. Checking into the hospitality industry or checking out for good. Make them even funnier. Booking a career. Elevator to success or stairway to nowhere. All right. Assume that someone criticizes the study sample of being too limited. Write a response. All right. Any other good arguments to justify my sample size? I think I liked the first response on the sample size a little bit better. I think I liked your first response on the sample size question better. Can you expand on that? All right, so ChatGPT can come up with research questions, formulate hypotheses, create survey items, determine sample sizes and sampling method, write the R codes needed to analyze the data, come up with theoretical implications and practical implications on the basis of the results, formulate titles for the paper, and it can also respond to reviewer criticisms. I would say that's pretty good. And what we did here, this is just a small example of what ChatGPT can do in terms of potentially changing how we teach business research and how we conduct and publish research. Universities should not ban ChatGPT. We have to use this. We should work with it and teach with it because it is simply too good not to be used. It would be a waste not to use it. And you know, my sense is that whichever universities that can make the best and fastest changes incorporating AI in their teaching will win out. This is going to change things. You can fight it. It's simply too good. It's not perfect, but still, at this time, nothing else is as good as this. And I am pretty sure that this is only going to get even better in the future.